Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Tennis Indoor Senayan Stadium here in Jakarta. It is the third day of competition in the Axiata Cup, and I can tell you what, this is absolutely amazing. The noise levels, the extraordinary cacophony of sound inside this stadium is amazing. We all know that Indonesia is an amazing place for watching badminton. We didn't know that they could get so noisy and really passionate about watching the Axiata Cup 2012. It's something special. Third day of competition, and I have to say that we have been witnessing some extraordinary matches so far, and Indonesia have come through very strongly. The Indonesia group represented by Garuda together with Malaysia Leopards are 1 and 2 in the sequence of Group J, and Vietnam and Singapore pulling up the rear at the moment. But there you go, that is the standings of Group J. Indonesia Garuda play 2-1-2. In fact, in their matches already played, they've only in fact lost one game. It's 12-1 in terms of the game performances. Malaysia Leopards have won 10 and lost 6. That's the way things are standing in Group K. That means Kuala Lumpur. Malaysia Tigers are at the top together with Indonesia Rajawali. But again, it will be game differences that will count. And on that, in that occasion, in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia Tigers lost one game. So they are, in fact, strictly speaking, behind Indonesia Rajawali, the second stringers for Indonesia. Thailand and Philippines are in third and fourth place in Kuala Lumpur, but all the attention here is right now on Jakarta and the entry of the teams to compete. Malaysia coming in first. Oh, what an atmosphere for these youngsters. This is the wannabe team. They are called Malaysia Leopards Macan Tutul. They are really, really enjoying this atmosphere. And son of Mizbun Ramdan comes in now. He will be challenging Taufik Hidayat in the opener. Iskandar Sulgaiman. And there, that was Zulfadli Zulkifli. Zulfadli Zulkifli will not be playing in this one. The second singles will be Iskandar Sulgaiman. That's not to say that Zulfadli will not be involved in next week's encounters in the semi-finals. Right, now, all the fuss, all the shouting, all the screaming and all the noise is about the Indonesian Garuda squad. Sonny Dwi Kuncoro we just saw go through. There's Marcus Kido, but he's not playing. A real surprise is that Hendra Setiawan is teamed up with Mohammad Ahsan. Setiawan with Ahsan will be the doubles pairing for Indonesia. You saw Ahsan coming through the picture there, and now we'll be waiting very patiently for one of the great heroes of badminton, not just Indonesia, but worldwide. It's the smoke, the lights, the thumping music. It's Taufik Hidayat. And even he has a real, real kick out of walking into an atmosphere like this. The former world and Olympic champion, of course, from the mid 2006-2005 period. He was the world champion in Anaheim, from Anaheim, and 2004, of course, the Olympic champion from Athens. So Anaheim was 2005, of course, in the men's singles. Men's singles champion in Doha 2006 and in Busan in 2002 in the Asian Games. Thomas Cup gold medalist in 2002 and in Kuala Lumpur in 2000. So anybody that thinks that they can walk down the street beside, walking beside Taufik Hidayat and not get recognized, well, you should come to Jakarta. It's unbelievable passion for the sport and passion for their heroes. The Axiata Cup is the ASEAN Men's Team Championship, the first and inaugural time it's been held. It's in Kuala Lumpur and in Jakarta. We'll have the semi-finals next week, of course, on a home and away basis in Jakarta and in Malaysia. And Axiata, the group from Malaysia, the one of the Asia's largest telecoms group, to be congratulated on this initiative. A very, very impressive first weekend of competition. The preliminary rounds coming to a closure this day. But of course, the initiative created by Total Sports Asia, TSA, in association with the BAC, the Badminton Asian Confederation, of course, very, very important in their support. And BAM and PBSI and all the other associations have put together their brains and initiated a fabulous new tournament that is being talked about all around the world. $1 million in prize money being competed for over the next 4 weekends, 3 weekends of competition, and it is very, very exciting. I am absolutely delighted to be bringing it to you. Age 31 now, Mizbun. Can't be right. I don't believe so. Rank 31 maybe, but I'll check that out. But Mizbun, I spoke with him just before coming over here myself from the hotel, and he knows the challenge that he faces here. It is something very, very big. You can get Taufik Hidayat on a bad day and you might push him close, but it would need to be a very bad day in Jakarta to stand a chance against him. This will be a huge test for Mizbun and all his team. And he's smiling ruefully, I no doubt. He knows he's got huge opposition here. I've never heard hooters and drums and cymbals and animated supporters in Jakarta like it. It was mayhem in 2007 at the Thomas and Uber Cup at the Astora Senayan. This new venue here in Senayan also, but across the park at the indoor tennis area, is proving to be a huge and spectacular one. There's our umpire for this one, Krysing Tongtup from Thailand. He's assisted by service judge Manit Chaumongkong, also of Thailand. Here we go. Third preliminary round, Malaysia against Indonesia. First blood, Mizbun. Malaysia Leopards, Macan Tutul against Indonesia Garuda. That's great start from Mizbun. You have to say he's got really nothing to lose. Everyone expects Taufik to beat him, so he can relax a little bit. Oh, and a little bit lucky there in the net for 3-0. We will see Taufik notoriously slow starting. His record over the last 11 years has proven that. But he will settle, I'm sure, over the next half an hour or so and really give Mizbun a lesson in competition play. That's a great start, though, for Mizbun. 5-0. Great work. Even that replay shows that he's not only feeling good about his game at the moment, Mizbun. That was not a great retrieve. That's better. First time from Taufik that we have a score on the board at 1-5. That is super. Mizbun was right over that like a rash. Absolutely early control, brilliant. He anticipated it well, pushed it into a great position. Oh, that's a pity. That's his first real error.
2-6.
I think he's enjoying his moment in the spotlight here. And that is very impressive. Throughout that whole rally, Mizbun Ramdam was in absolute control. He was pushing Taufik all around the court, both to the net and to deep, and he looked to be absolutely superb. Great, great start for the youngster from Malaysia. And another brilliant drop shot. Wow, 8-2. This is brilliant stuff from Mizbun. He is in total control at the moment. What a great surprise. And this is one of the great things about the Axiata Cup. It gives opportunities for the youngsters to come forward and really challenge the established players. Now they have something really to cheer about. He's done it again. Absolutely superb drop shot. He's playing with a confidence, with almost a carefree air. It will be lovely to bottle that up. That is a wonderful, wonderful start for Mizbun. Just out. It's 10-3. I think on the earlier graphic you would have seen his age as 31. It's obviously not that. It's 21. Born in March the 16th, 1991, so it would make his dad feel old if he really was 31, I can tell you. That's a better shot. The first time we have seen fireworks from Taufik. He's not looking comfortable at the moment, though. getting to that interval is proving a little harder than he first thought. He's really now got to be very watchful, because the moment that Taufik starts getting any kind of positive feeling, watch out. That is another great drop shot, this time onto the backhand side at the net. We go to the break in the first game. It's 11 points to 5. A Malaysia Leopards representative, Ms. Bun, is doing a fantastic job at the moment. And you have to say that Hendrawan will be really, really delighted with the way he's started this matchup. And again, the crowd really getting into this. It's a... oh, man. I mean, it is white and red all around this stadium. He's wearing white and red, and he's trying to bring his supporters into it. But at the moment, it is not... it is not happening for Taufik Hidayat, but don't discount him right now. 11 points to 5, he's down, but he's having to chase around a little bit, and I'm sure he will find a way. That's out.
12-5.
So... Ms. Bun in great shape at 12-5 at the moment. This is there on that angled shot into the drop. 6-12, and you just would not at this moment believe that the hero of Jakarta and Indonesia is feeling good about himself. He's just under a bit of pressure. That one short at the net. It's a fabulous setup, a really, really interesting new concept from TSA and from Axiata and the BAC. And on this third day of competition, we're getting more and more people interested in the fact that it's such a big, big competition in terms of the money on offer. We are in the Senayan Tennis Center. It's now getting up into the tennis kind of prize money. When you're looking at $1 million, my goodness, that is an extraordinary movement forward in badminton circles. Lost a little bit of accuracy here, maybe tightening up a fraction is Ms. Bun. He's just got to keep relaxed as he was for the first few points. Taufik stalking him now from behind at 9-12. And an unforced error there from Taufik. That is brilliant. Well, I can tell you now, if Datuk Misbun Sidek is watching this at the moment, he must be really, really pleased with what he's seeing in these opening exchanges on the third day of competition. 14-9, and Misbun Ramdan is absolutely flying at the moment. He's got a great control of the shuttle, and you have to say, he has got to just hang in here, keep calm, keep cool, and take this first game, put pressure on the 30-year-old legs of Taufik Hidayat. Just short there. Accuracy and consistency is everything in this sport. 10-15. Yeah, he tried to dummy it. And he missed there on the forehand.
11-16.
11-15. Misburn, keep your concentration. That's better. Good rally this. This is a good hunting rally. Brilliant stuff, both sides. Oh, off the top of the net and down onto Malaysia's side. Wow, great rally developing, and there suddenly Taufik pulls one out of the bag. Look at that backhand, unbelievable. That was the pressure point, but it almost came back from Misbud. Just caught the tape and decided to come back onto Malaysia's side. This is now a very crucial point. Three the difference at 12-15. Oh dear, that's loose. That's loose, that's wild, that's pressure.
13-15.
Again, Taufik misses one.
16.
Normally, he's so consistent with those kind of half-court attempts. There was a little bit too much pace on it. He maybe should have taken off the pace and come with a little bit more height. But that at 16-13, the hopes of Misbun remain for this opening game. It's a fabulous atmosphere here inside the Senayan Tennis Indoor Center. That's, oh, it was touched. Well, I would love to see that one again because I think it may well have been going out. Let's have a look at it. Difficult to say. I think maybe Musbun had to play it. Yeah. It just had that extra bit of power and pace on it. 14-16, a long service. Oh, it's gone over and it's in. Oh, scratch of the head time for Taufik. He could not believe that crept over the net. Well, they say fortune favors the brave, and certainly Misbud is the brave one at the moment. And look at this, 18-14. Wow. Oh, what a feather in the cap if he manages to upset the Olympic and former world champion. It's there. That is 19-14. A brilliant, brilliant drop shot off the forehand side. Cross court down into that forehand at the net. It's a beauty. 19-14. A cheeky little chip from Taufik. You get the impression that Taufik could up his game in a while, but at the moment, Misbun is doing brilliantly. He's got it, 20-15, look at this. Well, I know you're watching this live in Malaysia as well. You must be delighted, all you fans out there, of this young man, Misbun Ramdan. It's game point. And that is it, it's 21-15, and Taufik was not interested in prolonging it. Wow. Well, that means that the sound inside this stadium has just gone down a few decibels. The horns are still there, but the passion is certainly not. What's going on between the coach and Taufik? He's heard it all before, of course. He knows. How many times have we said it in Super Series events, in World Championships? He's a slow starter. Well, I don't think he could do much about that, to be quite honestly, because Misbun was excellent. Coming coming back to court, and again the red and white flags. They are now hoping for the best. In terms of the results so far, Jakarta and Indonesia Garuda are in the lead in this four-team group. It's Garuda, Indonesia Garuda, followed by Malaysia Leopards. They're competing now with each other. Vietnam and Singapore in third and fourth spot overall. And just today's preliminaries to finish off. But this will be a great Philip, and I tell you what, Hendrawan will be absolutely delighted with what he's seen so far. Now, this is the big test. What will Taufik do about this? He's 1-0 down. That's wide.
So we go over. One long.
I've been looking at some of the blogs, and people are worried about the movement there. You can see on the screen at the back. And whether it will be distracting, don't worry about it, because it's actually at the court side, it is a blank green A board. There you can see it's green. It's the wonders of technology and extraordinary ability to bring these things up with new technology. That is the secret. Axiata, innovative, bringing this new form of advertising and sponsorship to badminton. It's in there, and Taufik plays an unbelievable retrieve. The best rally of the match so far, and Taufik at his unbelievable best. The magician, Harry Potter. Amazing. He was going to leave it because this line closest to me, and that was the final point, but halfway through that rally, of course, he was going to leave it, then suddenly played it, and it was a magnificent, accurate drop shot at the net. He's now flowing. Mizpah has got to keep his concentration here. Taufik has gone into fourth gear. He's not in fifth or sixth yet, but he's certainly in fourth. That's way long for 5-0. And of course, with the all the activities at Sepang today up in Malaysia with the Formula One, I guess that's quite a nice analogy. Zero. Can you believe it? The turnaround between one and two. Yeah, that's a great shot. That was beautifully conceived. That was a real, real beautiful rally. Set it up down into the corner with the drop and then fixed it with a cross-court smash. Beautifully placed. And again, it's too long. One of the great things about Taufik, he understands everything about this game. He's got brilliant line radar. He knows exactly where the shuttle is. It's a huge indoor stadium, this, in terms of the feel. It's very, very high roofed, high ceiling. But Taufik has got perfect understanding of where the shuttle is in relation to the court. 8-1 in the second, having lost the first. He's short on that drop.
2-8.
There's a just little nerve creeping in here. He's probably so relieved to take a game from Taufik. He's probably forgotten that he's got to go continue and take another one. Wow, that was very, very poor. He didn't leap for it. He was going to leave it, decided to actually play it, and he should never have got his racket near it. 3-9. It's short at the net. He went for the lift, missed it. And again, some brilliant cutaways of the crowd enjoying themselves. They can see Taufik now getting back into some kind of form. Fabulous. Two great backhands there. One cross court, one down the line, very flat. Brilliant stuff to get to the interval in the second game. 11-3, what a turnaround. What a matchup. One of the great things about the Axiata Cup is that you're going to see the new guys on the block, the old established players competing against each other. It's a fantastic concept. Normally, Super Series events or regular tournaments, you wouldn't have that privilege. All the youngsters will probably be knocked out in the earlier rounds. But here we see the old and the new getting together, and it's a fascinating prospect.
20 seconds.
Taufik has taken a little time to warm up. Not unexpected, but now he's showing great, great style.
11-3.
That's a brilliant cross court. Lots of pace and power. Great. Watch the wrist come over here. Brilliant. Fabulous angle. One's gone as well. Taufik is absolutely cruising in this second game. The amazing thing is, I had a word with Mizbun Ramdan earlier, and I said, you know, you've got to be really, really wary of this end in terms of the breeze, the wind. I wasn't trying to put him off. It was about 2 hours before the match, but 80% of all the errors have been made at this end, closest to camera. And again. Taufik is just moving with such brilliant, brilliant efficiency. Very impressive. That's what pressure does. Normally he wouldn't snatch at a backhand like that. But he's trying to kill the shuttle in the rally. He's not being patient there. That didn't even go halfway up the net. It's 14-5. That is superb, quintessential Taufik Hidayat. Softens him up and then delivers the coup de grace down the line. 15-5. I think that Mizbun Ramdan has got to remember that he's still in the lead in the match. He's got to lift his head, and that was out. 16-5.
16-5.
It's in. And again, the breeze that is affecting the shuttle towards the camera here is preventing it going out at the other end. line. It's a beautifully masterful rally from Taufik. His unpredictability is so predictable. Well, you get my meaning, don't you? You knew that he was going to struggle at the first to warm up, but now he's in his stride. Look at the scoreline. Fantastic serve. And that puts pressure on the opponent, of course, and at 19-5, Mizbon will wonder what the heck has hit him in this second game. He won the first brilliantly to 15. And even the net goes against him now. It was in his favour when he was at this end defending. 20 points to 5. It is game point in the second to Taufik. It was so close to being brilliant. It's out, it's game, it's 21-5. Taufik is back in this match, and no more than we expected, to be quite honest. He wasn't interested in the first game, but he was absolutely focused in this one. He's taken it by 21 points to 5, and that's got the crowd here really excited. These youngsters are being treated to a fabulous, entertaining afternoon of great badminton here, and I hope you are at home too. And I hope you catch the Axiata Cup fever as well, because there's lots of great matches to look forward to. We've got on TV alone, we've got four big matchups in teams every day. Two from Jakarta, two from Kuala Lumpur. And they're all including the best that Southeast Asia can offer. 30 years old now. Can't believe he's so well motivated. Of course, the $1 million cash at the end of the rainbow probably helps a little bit, but it's still, when he's playing at home, there's no doubt that Taufik is something special. Probably one of the most naturally gifted players that's ever picked up a badminton racket. Extraordinary. You see, Mizbon's inexperience, because it's the rubber game, they take a little bit longer between them. He was ready to go back, but it's 20 seconds to go even now, so just keeping that concentration, keeping the mindset positive is now the big challenge for Mizbon. Well, this is the end, as we set up at the moment, that Taufik struggled. Let's see whether or not he can start with a bang this time. One all, love all in the first. There was a bit too much power there, down the middle into the body. Aiming at the right hip pocket, and Mizbon just couldn't quite get away from it to play the forehand. It wasn't a great shot. Ooh, he means it. That was uncharacteristic. He picked up the big forehand retrieve and missed his favourite backhand. One all. Right, Mizbon, come on. Give us something to really shout about here. Be disappointed with that. It came straight at him. No real excuse for not keeping it in play. It started from that net cord play, but it went on the tape also from Mizvan, but then it came off the tape off the drop, and that is now suicidal shot because it was just vertical from the net. 3-1 Taufik. You know, Taufik made an error there. We were privileged to see it from very, very close up and in line, but he could have left that backhand. It was going wide. He chose to take it early. Mizvan took advantage. It's 2-3. And another big one. Oh, what a great retrieve. Aha, he was in two minds. That's the best shot you could possibly play, when you leave your opponent doubting that the shuttle is in and then realizing it will be. Fabulous drop shot there. Great competition at the net. Mizvan the winner there. Look at this. Oh, yeah, I don't think it's going to be in. Ouch. Lovely reaction shot there. ANTV in Indonesia, our production host, doing a great job. Well, he would have won the point because Taufik was back on his heels. An unforced error there from Mizvan. Taufik at 4-3. This is a much closer, tighter, intense affair. Taufik playing at his absolute top best at the moment. That's out. A disappointment there for Mizvan. Sure, Dad would say consistency, consistency. No good having one point and losing three. You've got to really keep the pressure on all the time. Yes, well done, Mizvan. You were under big pressure there. Taufik was looking better and better as the rally went on, but that was great, great thinking. Excellent play. Forcing the error there at 4-5. All the Axiata brands on show, XL particularly, obviously one that they're very keen to highlight. And there are others as well, Cellcom. Short, but it was a beautiful, beautiful super shot into the corner from Taufik. The interesting thing here is that Taufik is the only Indonesian player to lose a game. He lost in an earlier encounter against Singapore. And also, it's the only one that, an Indonesian player has lost. So he's now, they've lost two games in the competition. If it was going to be level, then they would look at the number of games won and lost as a decider. It's just out. And again, big disappointment there.
7-5.
And the Again, I draw your attention to the great atmosphere inside this Sanayan Indoor Tennis Center. It really is very special. And great that the BBSI and all the organizers here, the BAC, and of course the initiator TSA, putting on a really, really good show. Oh, a bit lucky. It took the take so hard. It bounced very, very high. Went to court at 9-5. Wow. No chance for Misbahn. There you go. Ah, you've got your XL on the cheek as well. Big backhand there from Taufik. We haven't seen it much of it, to be quite honest. Not his huge smash backhand, which is an extraordinary one. Oh yeah, great rally. Brilliant. Oh, that was just on the outside. It was millimeters from being absolutely wonderful. But we go to the break at 11-5 in the third and final game here in this opening encounter between Indonesia Garuda, represented by Taufik, and Malaysia Leopards, represented by Misbahn Ramdan. And I tell you, he'll be disappointed with that because he was so competitive. He retrieved everything. He kept the pressure on by moving Taufik everywhere around the court. It was almost the perfect rally for Misbahn. He just missed the line. Well, there's lots of chats and blogs online, both at the Axiata Cup website. It is www.axiatacup.com for more information, and obviously player profiles and so on and so forth. But there's a lot of chat on Badminton Central and also Badzine about the whole Axiata Cup initiative. I hope it becomes positive because it is a very, very good concept. Just out. They've changed ends, just in case you hadn't noticed. 6-11. Yeah, the point that I'm making is obviously in this year of the Olympics, there's some guy saying that it's probably a little bit of a distraction for the senior players. I don't see it that way. I see it as another opportunity for them to really, really be focused, and to play against new and upcoming opposition is very important when you're in an Olympic year. Well, both these players have absolutely delightful shots. Great work, Misbahn. He hung in there. It was a very, very... Well, not, it wasn't just a good finish, it was a very good looking rally, wasn't it? There was a lot of beautiful shots played within it. Both these players love to do things with style, great technique, but it's also got to look good as well. That was quite the opposite. That was ugly.
37.
Consistency is it's a big word and a big thing to try to do. Short. But the trouble is, you see, Taufik has already put a lot of money in the bank in this game. And even if he makes a couple of errors, it doesn't matter. He can still relax. He's got a great position here. Although Misbahn, if he picks up two or three points, it'll make a difference now. Good work. It was quick hands, threw very, very fast with the wrist. And it was a lovely, lovely flashing forehand there for 9-13. Yeah, that was unlucky. Again, it was into the body. The target. Well, Misbahn is familiar. Last year he was in Indonesia for the men's open singles Grand Prix gold event here, and he got into the last quarter. He also got into the Indian Grand Prix, which is coming up in a couple of weeks, into the last quarters. So he's moving into the seniors rankings very, very nicely. But looking at how he performed in the first game with such confidence, so loose and free and strong, and look at this. Is that I guess that's a kind of Indonesian goth, is it? We're gonna spill blood around here. It's gonna get fierce. Oh, great work there, unlucky, it's out. But great work from Taufik to pick that one up and play it so brilliantly after delaying so long. 16-9. Since that first game, I'm afraid Misbahn has struggled to make any impact. Lost the second one to 5. And although this has been a little bit more competitive, he just hasn't been able to put more pressure on Taufik. The trouble is, of course, he responds so well to pressure. He's been there and done it so many times. He's got an ambition to really carry the flag. And there, Hendra won. He knows a little bit about what happens in Indonesia. The expectation is high, and the delivery from Taufik is no more than that expectation. It's very impressive. 17-9. And now it's 18-9. There hasn't been one shuttle gone long at that end. Taufik is in the zone. He's enjoying himself. He gave Misbahn an opportunity in the first, which he took gratefully, but since then it's been masterclass. 20-9. And I hope when Misbahn watches the replay of this, he picks up and learns a lot from it. He's got all the shots that Taufik has got, there's no doubt about that, but it's the opportunities and the options of when to play them. little bit of showboating on the backhand from Taufik, and another one. He wants to win it in style. Match point, but it's not going to happen yet. 10-20. Well done, Misbahn. It's psychologically very tough for the youngster. The 21-year-old against the 30-year-old. At some stage, Misbahn will have the game to beat Taufik. There's no doubt at all about that. But will Taufik be around long enough to witness it? Oh, yes, backhand! One of the most explosive backhands in world badminton ever. Wins it for Taufik Hidayat, 21-10 in the third. And that really was a very, very good example of everything that is brilliant about Axiata Cup play. The old master, the young pretender, comes out of the blocks really, really fast, takes the first lap in his stride and is absolutely flying. Then the old master comes back, and for the second two games he shows how to win matches. It was a brilliant exhibition. Taufik acknowledges the crowd, and you have to say Indonesia looking good for a place in the finals after they get through the semi-finals next week, which they're guaranteed, of course, of being in already. The Indonesian fans love it. Taufik has done his job. He's won 3 out of 3. Misbahn also played a huge part in that, and ultimately couldn't be sustaining his ability against the onslaught from a former world and Olympic champion. Taufik reigns supreme in Jakarta.